Let me tell you how I started, because that's very important. It was, I know the date also, it was August 8 or August 9, 1977. That was the day the London-Sydney rally was passing through Pune. Me, my three younger brothers, a bunch of other like-minded friends who loved cars, bikes, we said we got to see these cars properly. And the best way to see this car is on Carthage Ghat, because they'll be slow on the corners. So, we went there. I still, when I go to Carthage Ghat, that one long hairpin turn which is there, that's the start of everything which happened for me.
Still remember, I started buying petrol at 2 rupees. I used to bring half a liter of petrol. I started riding at that time. In 96, I was going for this auto expo. It was the fourth also auto expo, I think so. I went there and I was waiting in front of the Royal Enfield stall, which was there at auto expo, to see which bike they are launching. So now they raised the curtain from a bike which was known as City Bike. It was a 500cc bike. As soon as they raised the curtain, I said, I want this bike. This is the bike which I want. I just got in love with that bike and that first glance of it. In 2004, I went for a ride to Chennai. And I had parked my bike outside the main gate of Royal Enfield. And across the gate only at some distance, I had gone to have some cold drink over there with my friend. After some time, I just looked and I could not see my bike. People, the employees of Royal Enfield, as all the workers inside had gathered around my bike and they were discussing something in that local language over there. I could not understand. I just pushed one or two and I went and I stood there. But I could not understand. They were touching parts of my bike and speaking something. I caught hold of the local friend over there. I told him, come here, you can understand Tamil. You please see what they are speaking. And he translated them and he said, that guy is saying that he made that mudguard. The other guy is saying that he connected the wiring. And they really caught my hand and they were so happy to see that bike again. They made it. That was a masterpiece bike. They made it with their hands. It was not like a normal bike which is made in production, but it was, you can say, a handcrafted, handmade bike.
My uncle's grandfather brought the first motorcycle to India in 1903. He organized the first ever motorcycle race in India from Pune to Kolhapur and back in 1904-1905. The first ever road race meet in India was held at the Loigaon circuit in 1937. It's not Chennai, it's not anywhere else. Then from 1948 to 1965, Pune was the hub of all road racing at the Loigaon circuit.
In our building's parking, you know, it was just like any normal other parking of the 1990s. You had a few boring Marutis, probably the rich guy had a Ford, you know, but in all this sea of bland, boring sheet metal, you know, there was this one particular bike. The thing that was special about this bike, that it had two exhaust pipes. And it had a speedo that went all the way up to 200. And we had an Esteem back then, you know, and that speedo went up till like 160 or 180. So that was kick-ass. That was a bike faster than my car. And the guy who owned it, whenever he would come down, whenever we were playing, he would just come down evenings or mornings, start the bike. And anyone who's seen an RE350 being started, kick-started, it's an occasion, you know, and things sputters to life, that engine just sounds beautiful, and off he went, leaving behind a trail of blue smoke. So that was genesis for me. when I'm riding, I'm not thinking about anything in the world. All that is on my mind is, how do I get this corner perfectly? When do I brake? When do I downshift? When do I lean out? When do I dip in? When do I accelerate? That's it. All that I'm concentrating on is nailing this corner, then the next one, then the one after that, and the one after that. When I'm riding, it's just that. It's complete purity of thought, and that's it. I'm actually at peace with myself.
In the initial days, in fact, in the first week that I joined my club, Roadshakers, we have this pattern of meeting every Wednesdays and then going out for a ride on the weekend. So on the Wednesdays, we discuss our rides for the weekends. So the first weekend I was there, we planned to have a breakfast ride on Saturday to Mahabaleshwar. I mean, that was something I had like not heard of or kind of wasn't really used to, you know, riding to some place 200 kilometers away for just breakfast. So since that was my first ride with the club, with the bike, that was pretty memorable. Nothing too special on that, but it was just unique for me. So that's something I'll always remember. When I finished a year with her, I rode from here to Bangalore and back in 23 hours and 40 minutes, covered a distance of 1,678 kilometers or something, which made me one of the first 10 guys in India to get an Ironman certification.
I had an accident. I ruptured my left ACL ligament. Grade 4 rupture, so there cannot be any recovery without the operation. It's an elective surgery, of course, but it is a mandatory one. You have to get operated. I did not have Mediclaim, nothing. So I had around like a lakh rupee that I had saved. But at the same moment, this bike was launched. So I had two options, either buy this bike or get operated. And
I came across an interesting quote a few days back, you know. It goes like this, you know, I mean, if you can teach your son the love of motorcycling, you'll make sure he'll have enough money for drugs. So.
Everyone has their thing in life. You know, some people paint, some people sing, some people play the guitar. So for us, people like us, we have motoring, we have cars, we have bikes. And they're not just a few wheels and an engine put together in a metal body. It's much more than that. It's human. It has its own personality. A passion for bikes, it is something that really pushes people to the brink of madness. That's the sort of lunacy that engulfs you, your mind, and your every conscious of your being. There's a proverb in Hindi, Zehn mein aa jata hai. It engulfs you.